Hi everyone, welcome back to another video on Snowflake. In this video, we're going to take a look at your query history and review the execution plan to perhaps performance tune and optimize your queries. So the first place you can look to get a history of all of the queries that have been run on your server is to go to this history tab up here at the top. And when you get in here, you'll see something that looks like this. And this is a table of just about every query that's been run. Everything gets a query ID, and it shows the actual text that was run, as well as a bunch of other information, the user, the warehouse that was used. And what we'll look at here is what I think is actually a really intuitive way to really get into the weeds of individual queries and see maybe where some problems lie. So first off here, let's look at the different filter options. With status, you can look at ones that are running, some that have failed, and it's pretty quick. I mean, granted, this is not a huge environment that I have, but you can see, you know, here are all the failed queries. Maybe there's some common traits in there that you could look at. By user, a specific warehouse. Duration, let's say I want to look at any queries that are greater than 5 seconds. And you can see this is real time, just how quick that returns these results. And you can see, you know, the byte scan, duration, all this information. So if you have, you know, maybe some sort of SLA where you don't want anything to take longer than, you know, a minute or so or whatever, you know, you can quickly identify ones that are breaching that threshold. I like this one a lot right here, SQL text. Maybe you want to see all queries that have been written that include a certain table or some sort of phrase. You know, for example, I'll do get DDL. I know I've run this recently. So a lot of great user-friendly ways of filtering these, which I think sets it apart from tools that I've used in the past where it really was a little difficult to get to this information. So let's just pop into one of these. Let's go, you know, one of the long running queries. And you'll see here, every query gets an ID. There's a lot of things in Snowflake where you can use this ID for certain things. And here, if we click on this ID, we can see the exact SQL text that was run, a preview of the results that were returned, and you can export the results here as well. So, you know, maybe if you ran something in the past and you wanted to get a copy of that exact result set that was run, this is a way you can do that and you won't lose it. And the second part here is profile. Here's where you can see the execution plan. It'll show you each step of the underlying query and you can dig into it and see some details on it, how much of an individual step weighted on that query. You could see the breakdown of the individual components of that step itself, some attributes, even something like the table alias, the full name, the condition, the type of join, stuff like that. And in my opinion, compared to some of the other tools I've used in the past, this is a really nice way to look at this. It's really easy and adds a lot of detail in a very digestible way that you can use to analyze your queries and hopefully improve them. And now the last area I'd like to point out is on the Worksheets tab. If you go down here to where it says Open History, you can see what will effectively be a real-time look at your queries and what's going on. So let's, for example, run this query right here. As we run this, we can see it shows up here, the status. And obviously, that was a quick one. It went to succeeded. And you can get all of the same information here that we saw on the previous page. You know, it comes with a query ID, and if we were to click this, it's going to take us to this history tab, and now we're right back where we started, and we can dig into the specifics of it. So now let's just run a couple more queries. We'll see this one shows up just to get a view here. You know, you can see as we move along here for your individual session, you're able to see all of the queries that you ran, and you can dig back into them and work with it. And as we mentioned before, there's a lot of things you can do with this query ID. Maybe you want to clone a table before or after a particular query was run. You could use that here. Or restore something before or after a particular query. You could do that as well. So that'll do it for this video. Really, I just wanted to go through the different features that Snowflake offers here for query history and understanding the breakdowns in terms of analyzing your queries and performance tuning and really optimizing what you're doing here on Snowflake. You know, Snowflake makes it really easy to get this information and to work with it. And it can really separate you from being just an average data developer, engineer, to someone who's a little more advanced. Thanks as always for watching. If you found it helpful, please feel free to like the video. It really does help the channel. And if you really like it, feel free to subscribe as well. I'll continue to upload videos like this. Thanks for watching.